to all of you. Welcome to Not By Bread Alone, our Lenten devotional, and we can call it a pilgrimage on our way to Easter. This is Pastor Yeti. We are in our second week of Lent, and today I'm going to talk about what we carry. Our readings are from Isaiah 1, verse 10 and verse 16 to 20, and Matthew 23, verses 1 to 12. Scripture. They tie up heavy burdens, hard to carry, and lay them on people's shoulders. But they will not lift a finger to move them. Matthew 23, verse 4. Reflection. The desert of Lent feels very familiar to us. We have been in the desert a long time, far longer than this Lenten season. We are journeying across scorched ground, thirsty, desperate, hoping that all that has been hidden, all that has caused pain, will finally be uncovered and laid bare. For the people in the church, for people who are abused, it's a very hard burden to carry. Our shoulders are bent under its weight. Our spirits are listening as we wait for relief. Something that buoy us up and take us to calmer, clearer waters. I'm sure many reading Jesus' words today could not help but connect the dots to the scandal of today, of the pain. Of the depressions. We are mirrored in the misdeeds of those who told us what to do, even as they did the opposite. Who preached but did not practice. Who wounded individual victims and, by extension, the larger faith family, but would not lift a finger to set things right. Many have left because they could not continue under the heaviness of it all. Others stay weakened and parched, but convinced that the relief that is down the road is more than just a mirage. A mirage. We keep our eyes on Jesus, knowing that He is our only Master, and we are not willing to forsake our fate for the sins of wolves in shepherd's clothing. misuse and abuse. We can find it in all the places of the world. Your meditation. Has your faith life been affected by the traumas that has left you in a spiritual desert? Try to put aside the news that are causing you to struggle and doubt. The news that shows you more of many so other people that are abused, hurt. Go back to the basic. What do you believe in? Whom do you believe in? It's about the Father, the Son, and Spirit, and the powerful gospel message that is the foundation of your life. Don't let anyone leave you stranded in a spiritual desert, not of your own making. Keep moving. Keep praying. Keep gathering with your community. Keep focus on our Lord Jesus Christ. Keep contact with dear brothers and sisters, good friends. Let us pray. Dear God, we ask for fortitude and strength as we struggle against the anger, the doubt, and disillusionment. Help us see beyond the human failings within our faith to the love that can heal all our sorrows. In Jesus' name, amen. May God love you. In his unconditional love that you never experienced before. Try to keep in mind, maybe as little as you have in your faith, as we walk through this not by bread alone meditation, that it's painful for you. Know that he walks with you. We can have many questions on that particular moment when that hurt, misuse, abuse happened, where God was. And I'm not talking about easy about all this. We know that it's not all good in this world. And we as Christians should give that example in the way that Jesus walked on this earth. That we touch other people to heal, not to hurt. To set them free instead of bounding them. So my sister and my brother, It is Jesus that will heal you, will transform you, will strengthen you, and lift up your faith. I wish you and give with you Lenten abundant blessings as you walk in this pilgrimage, your way to Easter. Blessings, and bye.